Hello, and welcome to another Quick Tip Tuesday. Today I'm going to cover a new feature in Dropbox called File Requests. This feature was just added as of June 17, 2015, and it allows Dropbox users to request files from non-Dropbox users. You are now able to request files from those who do not have a Dropbox account. You can request a file up to 2 gigabytes. Yes, 2 gigabytes. Far larger than the limit on Yahoo Mail or Gmail that is only 25 megabytes. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the process of requesting a file using your Dropbox account, and then on the back end, how the person would then send that file in response to the request. And finally, what happens then in your Dropbox account once that file has been sent to you. Let's get started. Here we are looking at a screenshot of my Dropbox account. And if you look to the left, you are going to see a button called File Requests. Click on File Requests.
You're brought to this screen. Towards the top, you can see where it says open and closed. We are looking under the opened tab. Here it has this big square with the blue circle, request files. You're going to click on that button. Next, you're brought to this screen, create file request. You're going to type in the box what file you're requesting. For instance, the meeting notes from ... Whatever file you're requesting, you can type that in here. I'm just going to put in test for this example. Now you can see once I type in test, it also names the file test. You don't need to keep the same name for your file. You can change that. Just click on the blue letters that say change folder. Then click next. Next, you're brought to this screen, send file request. You are given a link and you can copy that link. When you click on copy link, it saves the link to your clipboard. Simply right click and hit paste to paste that link wherever you would like, such as an email or instant message, etc. The other option is the second box below where you can type in a name or an email address. I'm just going to type in an email address to where I'm going to send the link to. Then click Done. Once you've clicked Done, you're brought back to this screen, and as you can see at the top, it says your file request was sent. Will send you an email when someone uploads a file. And when you look to the right of the box that says Request Files, there's a new box labeled Test with 0 submissions. The 0 is because no one has sent you a file yet. Next, we're going to go to my email where I had sent the file request so that you can see on the back end what happens with the person who receives the file request.
Again, here we are looking at a screenshot, and that's just to show you that the request did land in my Gmail account, and now we're going to click on the request and see what happens. Here we are looking at a screenshot of the email that I received from Dropbox telling me, "Hi there, Tina sent you a request titled test. You can upload files to the Dropbox so that Tina can see them even if you don't have an account." Then you're given the option to click on a button for learn more or the big blue bar for upload files. Click on upload files. Here we are at the next screenshot. It's telling us that this person is requesting this file. And the person who requests the file is the only one that can see that file unless they share it. Now you would click on Choose Files, or if you're unsure about how this is all working, it allows you to click on How Does This Work? We're going to click on Choose Files. When you click on Choose Files, you are then taken into your files and folders where you can choose the file that you are going to upload. Go ahead and choose whatever file you would like to send. Your maximum file can be 2 gigabytes. That's pretty large. Here we are looking at the next screenshot after I have added the file that I'm going to share. So again, it's saying that I requested this file and only I will see the file unless I choose to share it. And now you have to enter your name and email address. I'm going to show you here, when I click upload, it's not going to take it unless I enter my name and email address. So you can see after clicking upload, it's not going to work unless you add your name, first name, last name, and email address. I'm going to enter those now and then click upload. You can also add another file by clicking these blue words right above the upload blue bar. It may take some time for the file to upload, especially depending on the size and your internet speed. Please be patient. The final page that the person receives who was sent the file request is this thank you page. They're also given the opportunity to now create a Dropbox account of their own. All they need to do is click on the blue box, create an account. Now let me make one note here. It is a benefit to those who do not yet have Dropbox to use the friends and family links, because when doing so, you get the benefit of an extra 500 megabytes of bonus space. Under this video, in the description box, I will include a friends and family link that offers the 500 megabytes of bonus space. You certainly can click on that link or just go directly to dropbox.com to get your Dropbox account. Now let's go back into our Dropbox folder and see the file that we have received. Here again on this page, as we had seen before, under File Requests, now under the second box for Test, instead of 0 submissions, it says 1 submission. And if you hover your pointer over the 1 submission, it gives you the option to edit or add people. When you click on the 1 submission, you are brought to the actual file itself, and when you again hover your pointer over the bar with containing the file, you see to the right then it says share, and that's where you're given the opportunity to share this file, or of course if you double clicked on it, it would open the file itself. So now I've taken you through the process of sending a file request using your Dropbox, what happens on the receiving end after getting a file request, and finally, what happens in your Dropbox when the file has been received. I hope you found this video useful on Dropbox file requests. If you did, please be sure to click on the like button. Also, subscribe to the channel to make sure that you catch all upcoming tips and other videos. If you have any suggestions for upcoming tips or other videos, please leave a comment below this video. You can also reach me on Facebook and Twitter. If you're looking for transcription services, please go to my website, vomtranscriptionservices.com. Thanks for watching and see you next week.